Will from MinIO here with a Java how-to on creating buckets in MinIO. And we're going to be using OpenJDK 19 and Maven 4 to manage all of our Java work. And we're going to be connecting out to play.min.io, our online sandbox where anybody can work with the MinIO platform. And all of this is going to be run out of VS Code. And in this video, we're going to be calling that make bucket method. And in order to call that method, you need to set up some make bucket args. Additionally, we're going to take a look at how to check your results to make sure that you're actually creating a bucket when you ask for one. So let's take a look at some code. And here in our code, I've set up this static demo method. My main method is going to call the demo method after creating a MinIO client for me, doing some little setup. My main method is also going to handle all my exceptions for me. So if I get any exceptions, the main method is going to handle it. It's going to print out any exception information that I have. That's so I can focus in on just the details that I want to take a look at today. And today we're working with this make bucket method here on line 33. Now, that make bucket method, what you really need to give it, at the very least, is a bucket name. And the way that we do this is we wrap this in a bucket args object. So we call this make bucket args builder up on line 29. And I'm just giving it a bucket name. Now, there are a couple of other features that I could hand to this. When I'm creating a bucket, I could give it a region, like so. Or I could even give it some object lock settings if I want to set up some object lock. But that's really what I can do with the make bucket args object. The nice thing about this is that now that I've got my make bucket args, I simply call make bucket and my bucket is created. Now, how do I know that? Because the make bucket method doesn't actually return anything. It throws some exceptions, but it doesn't actually return anything. So what I'm going to do to check that is I'm going to call a method called bucket exists. And in order to call bucket exists, which gives me a true or false, I need to have a bucket exists args object. And I'm going to set this up the exact same way. I'm going to give it the same bucket name that I did before, build it out, and then I'm going to call that. And of course, if I was successful, I will get this bucket exists to print out the bucket name and the word exists. And if it's unsuccessful, then it does not exist. So let's go ahead and we're going to save this and we're going to build this and run it. So mvn clean package, because I'm building an executable jar file with this. And what I will do now is I'll run a Java jar target demo. And when I run this, what do I get back out? Easy as pie. Java demo bucket exists, and we're good to go. Now, if I run this a second time, because I'm actually trying to make the bucket before I check if it exists, what do I get? I actually am going to get an exception. And this exception basically says your previous request to create the named bucket succeeded, and I already own it, so I can't create the bucket twice. And of course, if I was checking for a bucket name that I hadn't already created, then I would get that does not exist. So in point of fact, this demonstration that I did is kind of in the opposite order. Generally speaking, I'd want to make sure it doesn't exist before I tried to create it. But that's everything that we have on creating a bucket using Java. I hope you've enjoyed this little demonstration. If you'd like to reach out to us, you can connect to us using any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can always work with us interactively on minio.slack.com. And last but not least, you can always leave us a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.